Welcome to this tutorial in the Mongoose Foundation's training series. In this tutorial, we will talk about how the Mongoose Form Control Utility and the IDEO Editing Forms provide multi-developer capabilities, such as check-in, check-out, and locking of forms and IDEOs. We will demonstrate how to check-in and check-out both forms and IDEOs. We will discuss the value of using a source control system when doing application development in Mongoose, mention the source control systems that Mongoose supports, and describe what must be done to set up a source control system to work with Mongoose. And finally, we will show how source control integrates with both form control and the IDEO editing forms during development operations. When developing your Mongoose-based application, the Mongoose framework provides the ability to control versions of the application as it changes and grows. And if you are extending an application from a vendor, Mongoose protects your application automatically during upgrades. It also provides the ability for multiple developers to work on your application in the same environment without accidentally overwriting changes made by others. For example, Mongoose supports the typical development case of checking out something to work on it, which keeps it locked so other developers cannot accidentally overwrite changes to it until the developer checks it back in. If you have multiple developers using Mongoose in your environment, you need to understand how this support is provided and how to configure it. Mongoose's support for these capabilities follows two models, one for forms metadata and another for IDEO metadata. If you want to protect your form-related metadata so that it is safe for multiple developers to work in the same environment, you must set up form control, which involves the use of a master forms database referenced in your configuration. Note that the check-in, check-out mechanism is already enabled in form control for form-related metadata only. With IDEO-related metadata, you operate out of a single object's database, and you use the IDEO editing forms for check-in and check-out operations. Let's start with the Form Control Utility, which is one of the primary utilities that Mongoose developers use for their work. Form Control is actually available in two formats. There is a standalone version, typically available only on the application server, and Form Control is also now available as a form within Mongoose itself. The functionality of these two formats is virtually identical, but for our demonstration, we will use the standalone version. You might recall that we are actually set up to work with Form Control already. We set that up using the Configuration Manager in the previous tutorial. So, let's use the Configuration Manager to open the Form Control utility for our configuration. Select our configuration and click the Form Control button. When Form Control opens, notice that across the top we have a set of option buttons that allow us to select the action that we want to perform. We'll demonstrate a couple of these a little later. The bottom of this utility then displays the contents of one of the four tabs. The Forms tab allows you to check forms in and out and perform other operations on forms only. The Global Objects tab is where you can work with other Mongoose form-related objects, such as variables, strings, images, component classes, themes, and so on. The tab labeled My Checked Out Objects allows you to see a complete list of all the forms and global objects you currently have checked out, including forms and objects you might have created but not yet checked in. And finally, the Utilities tab provides options for synchronizing your various databases. Let's see how to use the Form Control utility to check a form out and then check it back in. We start by making sure the Forms tab is selected, and then we use the Master Form Name drop-down list to select a form. Any form will do. Notice that when we select it, the Exists in Runtime field displays True. This tells us that there is already a copy of that form in the runtime database. Assuming no one else has the form checked out then, the Locked by User field should remain empty. To actually check out the form, we make sure that the checkout option is selected and then click Execute Action. When the system prompts for confirmation, we click OK and Form Control proceeds to check out the form. Notice that now the Locked by User field indicates that we have the form checked out. It is now locked and no one else can check it out until we check it back in. To check the form back in, we must first select the tab labeled My Checked Out Objects. To see a list of all the form related objects we have checked out, we will click the Display List button. The Checked Out Objects grid displays only one object, the form we just checked out. Let's select that entry and, noticing that the check-in action is already selected for us, we again click Execute Action. Form Control prompts us for confirmation and we click OK. Form Control then lets us know that the check-in was successful. As we mentioned earlier, the check-in and check-out of IDO-related metadata works a little differently. We have explained in previous tutorials that intelligent data objects, or IDOs as they are called, comprise the majority of the business logic in Mongoose applications. We will learn more about these objects as we go along in this series of tutorials, but we need to point out one of the key differences between IDOs and forms, and that is how they are controlled in Mongoose. You might recall that the IDO-related metadata resides in the objects database and not in the forms database. This has a few ramifications. Because form control works only with forms-related metadata, it has no effect on anything we do with IDO-related metadata, like IDOs, tables, and so on. There is no separate objects database for development and production like there is with forms. This means that all IDO-related metadata is checked in and out of a single database. And check-in and check-out of IDO-related metadata is done directly from the appropriate IDO-related forms in Mongoose. Here we see one of the primary IDO-related forms in Mongoose, the IDOs form. Notice that near the right side of the form, there is a button labeled Checkout and another immediately below it labeled Undo Checkout. You guessed it, these are the buttons we use to check IDOs in and out of the objects database. Next to those buttons are two read-only fields. The Locked By field serves the same purpose as the Locked By User field in Form Control, namely to indicate who currently has the IDO checked out, if anyone. The Access As field indicates who owns this selected IDO. We will talk about the Access As identifier more in a later tutorial, but for now, all you need to know is that if this field indicates that the owner is core, you cannot check it out or make lasting changes to it. So let's select an IDO we created earlier for test purposes. Notice that the Checkout button is now enabled. When we click it, Mongoose checks the IDO out to us and shows that it is locked by us. To check the IDO back in, we simply click the same button, which is now labeled Check-in. The system prompts us for a comment. With IDO-related metadata check-ins, you must enter a comment of some kind, even if it is only gibberish. If you do not, Mongoose aborts the check-in. Notice too that because we do not yet have a source control system set up, there is no source control repository for Mongoose to check the IDO into. But Mongoose can, and does, still check the IDO back into the objects database. Okay then, now that we have seen how check-in and check-out operations work for both form-related metadata and IDO-related metadata, let's take a look at source control and what that adds to the mix. Whether you are working with forms or IDOs, one of the key tools that can integrate with Mongoose to provide additional control is a source control system. The use of source control is optional, but it does provide some key benefits, such as version history and control, and the ability to use the metadata files checked into source control for things like distributing upgrades and fixes to your customers and users. It also allows for reversion to earlier versions in cases where changes have unexpected and undesirable consequences. If you want your form and IDO objects to be further protected by a source control system, you must create a source control repository, ensure that at least one user ID exists that can use that repository for development, and verify that they both work with Mongoose. Mongoose supports three popular source control systems: Microsoft Visual Source Safe, Microsoft Team Foundation Server, and Apache Subversion. In this tutorial, we will show how to configure the system to work with Visual Source Safe, but the other source control systems are very similar. For the particulars on Team Foundation Server and Subversion, see their respective documentation sets and the Mongoose Online help. Once installed and configured, the source control system specifically interfaces with Mongoose to control two basic groups of metadata: metadata that resides in the forms database, such as form definitions and form-related objects, and metadata that resides in the objects database, such as IDOs, IDO property classes, and IDO extension classes. It is worth mentioning, too, that Mongoose does not apply source control to metadata, T-SQL code, or data definition languages, or DDLs, that reside in your application database, such as application event system handlers and actions, table definitions, and so on. Any .NET IDO extension class source code you write, and if you are using Mongoose to extend an application from a vendor, source control does not check in or check out the vendor versions of the forms and IDO metadata. Instead, these are automatically upgraded into your application with the vendor's updates. The procedure to create a source control repository for use with Mongoose varies a little from one source control system to another. It is beyond the scope of this tutorial to provide that procedure for any of them, and we recommend that you consult the documentation available for your source control system. The bottom line is that before you can set up your source control system to work with Mongoose, you must have the repository created and accessible. Just by way of providing an example, let's take a moment to verify and view our VSS repository. Launching the VSS client, we sign in and locate, and then open the VSS database we have designated as our repository. When we do, notice that it is an empty database, but it is there. If you recall, a requirement for our source control setup is that we have at least one user ID we can use to access the source control repository. Well, actually, in our case, we already have one. When we created the repository itself, VSS used our login ID to create a VSS user, or really, three users. An admin user, which cannot be deleted or edited, a guest user, which can be used for guest logins, and the user ID we used to log into VSS when we created the VSS database. So, it turns out that in the act of adding the VSS database, we also created a user ID we can use to log in and use it. We recommend, though, that you create additional user IDs on your source control system, one for each developer who will be authorized to create and customize forms. This makes it easier to keep track of who is doing what in the development databases. We should also mention that at least when using VSS, we recommend that the VSS user ID be the same as for the Mongoose user developer who will be using it, though the password should be up to the individual user. And once again, we must point out that Team Foundation Server and Subversion both have their own requirements for accessing the source control repository. For specific information and instructions, consult the appropriate documentation for those systems and the Mongoose Online Help. So, now what we need to do is to edit our Mongoose configuration to enable it to use the source control system we have set up. We begin by opening the Configuration Manager, remembering, of course, to run it as administrator. In the Configuration Manager, we select the configuration for our application and then click Edit. This opens the Edit Configuration dialog box for our configuration. To set up source control to work with this configuration, we must do three things. On the Form Control tab, near the lower right corner, locate the Source Control Enabled checkbox and select it. On the Objects Metadata tab, on the right side, locate the Source Control Enabled checkbox there and select it. Then select the Source Control tab. There are several things that must be configured on this tab depending on which source control system you are using. The first and most obvious specification is the Source Control System group box at the top. There, select the option for your source control system. We, of course, will select Visual Source Safe. The other setting requirements on this tab will vary according to which source control system you are using. In our case, we must supply only the server URL or path field value, so that Mongoose knows where to find the sourcesafe.ini file. Let's use the Browse button to locate the .ini file for our setup. We'll go ahead and click Browse. When the Select SourceSafe database dialog box opens then, we'll use it to navigate first to our server on the network where we created our source control repository, and then to the folder where we installed Visual SourceSafe. There, we should find the sourcesafe.ini file. We'll select it and then click OK. When we return to the Configuration Manager, the path should now look like this. To test and make sure that Mongoose can successfully connect to the VSS database, we'll click the Test Connection button. If all is set up properly, we see this success message. Notice that for VSS, we did not have to specify a user ID and password. We will actually specify that later for each individual user when we create user IDs in Mongoose. For now, all we need to know is that we can successfully connect to the VSS database repository. Alright then, we are now set up to use Form Control, and we have our source control system in place and enabled. What does all this mean in practice then? How does Mongoose interact with the source control system in runtime? Well, let's take a look. We're going to go ahead and see what happens in VSS when we check out a form and then check it back in. But before we do that, let's take a quick look at the current state of our database. Going to our database server, we again use the VSS client to examine our VSS repository. If you remember, currently our VSS repository is empty. Now let's go back to Form Control and select the Forms tab. We will go ahead and check out a form. Again, any form will do. Having done that, let's go back to our VSS client and see how checking out the form affected things there. Well, actually, as you can see, it hasn't affected things there at all yet. This is because all we have done is check out an already existing form, so our source control system doesn't yet acknowledge its existence. We must check in the form before source control recognizes it. Before we check in the form, though, we must make some small change to it. Otherwise, if source control does not recognize that there is any difference between the checked out version of the form and the one we are checking in, it will not register any change in the VSS database. So, we will take a slightly modified version of the form and then check it in. This time, source control prompts us for a comment. In Form Control, the comment is optional, but highly recommended. When using source control, the comment becomes part of the history for the form or form-related object, and allows you to keep a record of what exactly has been done to it and when. We'll enter one, and then click OK. Now that we've checked the form back in, let's see if that had any effect on our VSS repository. Sure enough, when we check our VSS repository database now, we see that a new root-level project folder labeled Form Control has been added. If we then expand that folder and take a look in the Forms Project subfolder, we see that the form we just checked in has now been added to the list of forms in Source Control, as well as being checked back into the Master Forms database. The process is similar when dealing with IDO-related metadata. Let's go back to our IDO's form and check out that test IDO we created. Again, just checking out the IDO has no effect on our VSS repository. So, let's go back and check it in again. We add the required comment and click OK. Now, when we return to our VSS repository, we find that another project folder labeled IDO metadata has been added automatically. And if we expand that project folder, we find that VSS has added our test IDO to the list of IDOs in the repository. To sum up then, in this tutorial, we talked about how the Mongoose Form Control utility and the IDO editing forms provide multi-developer capabilities, such as check-in, check-out, and locking of forms and IDOs. We demonstrated how to check-in and check-out both forms and IDOs. We discussed the value of using a source control system when doing application development in Mongoose, mentioned the source control systems that Mongoose supports, and described what must be done to set up a source control system to work with Mongoose. And finally, we showed how source control integrates with both form control and the IDO editing forms during development operations. So, what's next? In the next tutorial in this series, we will look at how to create a Mongoose user profile and use that profile to set up a developer work environment. For more information, including more tutorials and complete documentation, visit our Mongoose portal at https://mongoose.infor.com/portal. For technical support, visit the Infor Extreme support website at https://www.inforextreme.com and log an incident there. or feel free to contact us with your questions and comments at mongoose@infor.com. That's it for this tutorial. Until next time then, have a great Mongoose Day!